And so Oak Bluffs becomes really important because of the way that it allows people to think about not just New England and the history of African Americans in New England, but particularly questions of Black leisure. And so what we resulted in was collecting around two of the oldest cottages and guest homes in Oak Bluffs, the Scherer Cottage and the Powell Cottage, or otherwise known as the Bunny Cottage. What that allowed us to do was to provide a story of leisure, but also to really think about the complexities of leisure during segregation, the complexities of Black middle class life during this era.
Wanted to tell the story of African American leisure culture, specifically in the era of segregation. And we had a few choices to think about. We started talking about Oak Bluffs. It just seemed to make sense. There's a tremendous amount of history, but for the most part, it's underrepresented. You know, if you go up to the Vineyard, you know the Vineyard, and you might have an opportunity to learn a bit about the history, but it's just so rich and so vibrant, and we wanted to make sure that it had a spot on the National Mall as well.
To see it on display in the Smithsonian, it's really quite overwhelming, because you know, I know, we know as a family that it will always be there as long as there is the United States of America. The Smithsonian, you know, museums will be there, and Scherer Cottage and Oak Bluffs will be well represented. It brings you such pride in who you are as an individual, and it celebrates the contributions of African Americans over the years to our country, America. And it is an American story. You know, they say this isn't an African American museum. It is a museum of African American history and culture, but it's a museum about America.
Not just what leisure means, but what sanctuary means, what safe spaces mean, what having a place of one's own means. And that is, there's no better place, I think, to discuss those kind of questions than in Oak Bluffs.